Cells need ATP or energy to function and survive. ATP is made in specialized parts of the cell called mitochondria in a process known as the electron transport chain. In the electron transport chain, energy is produced when electrons are shuttled through the chain of protein complexes, like when money is made by selling and delivering newspapers to houses on a street. Newspapers have to be carried by a paperboy to get to each house, and so do electrons. One of the paperboys, or carriers of electrons, to each complex in the transport chain is the iron-sulfur cluster. At this point, you're probably wondering where frataxin fits into all of this. Frataxin, the protein deficient in FA, is critical for assembling these iron-sulfur clusters, or electron-shuttling paperboys. Without enough frataxin, there are not enough iron-sulfur clusters, so not enough energy is produced. Plus, electrons can escape the transport chain and become very reactive species, damaging the mitochondria and the cell. Experiments in cells and animal models have shown frataxin's role in creating iron-sulfur clusters is key to the electron transport chain, as well as many other important cellular processes. Because cells cannot survive without frataxin, we know that there are no substitutes for its function inside the cell, but we have the knowledge and technology to look for small molecules and small proteins that, when delivered to cells, could substitute for frataxin function. FARA is funding multiple investigators to carry out this challenging research. First, Benoit Dautreau and his team at the Institute for Integrative Biology of the Cell in Paris were able to build a system in a test that contained all cellular machinery that makes iron-sulfur clusters. Remember how frataxin plays a critical role in the assembly of the iron-sulfur cluster? He is using this system to see if any of 100K molecules could replace frataxin within the system and allow iron-sulfur complexes to be made and function normally without frataxin. The next step is to test the molecules discovered by Dr. Dautreau in a living organism that lacks frataxin. For speed of testing, these researchers are using a simple model, the fruit fly. If new molecules can rescue their frataxin-missing functions in the fruit fly, these compounds will be tested in larger animal models that have FA symptoms similar to humans. FARA also funded the research group of Javier Santos at the University of Buenos Aires to study the architecture of the cellular machinery that builds iron-sulfur clusters. So this research will help us understand if it is possible to increase the efficiency of this machinery, where there isn't enough functional frataxin. Dr. Santos and colleagues have found small proteins that can bind to and change the structure of frataxin, as well as proteins that bind to it and change the structure of other members of the machinery that builds iron-sulfur complexes. This toolkit of proteins allows the team to investigate how changing the structure of frataxin and other members of machinery can improve the performance of the machinery to produce iron-sulfur complexes more efficiently overall. These small proteins that bind to frataxin might someday be the treatment themselves, or they may provide clues to other therapeutic approaches. These are just two examples of FARA-funded research projects that are improving our understanding of the frataxin protein and discovering a variety of new treatment approaches. These projects also highlight the global effort of FA investigators to understand and develop treatments for patients with FA. Thank you for these research teams, as well as to the community for raising the money that funds these important research grants. Together, we will cure FA.
The project we just learned about is One Seed, One Tool, funded by your donations, championed by your engagement and your direct participation in FA research that is necessary to plant, tend, and nourish our garden of therapeutics. Thank you, FA community, for bringing us closer to treatments.